Editing static content in edit mode, like text or images, is as simple as clicking the element on the canvas. If you're in edit mode and see a blue outline when hovering over any static element, that means the content is editable. In fact, if you see an element with no outline, that means it's not supposed to be editable. But for elements you can edit, what you can do depends on what that content is. So, in this lesson, we're going to cover three ways to edit static content: how to edit text, how to edit links, and how to edit assets, like images. Let's start with text. When I click in to select this element, a little pencil icon appears to show I can edit the text. Click that, and I can now edit the text directly on the canvas. I can delete and replace words, or if I double-click, I can make simple formatting changes to make it bold, or italics, or superscript, or subscript. I can even turn text into a link. Speaking of links, let's move on to how to edit links. Link elements might be buttons or text, but they are all designed to link to something. So if I hover over this button here and then click it, I can see a little link icon. That opens the link settings menu, where I have multiple options. I can link this button to another site completely, another page on this site, or a specific section on this page. I could also have it send an email, or call a phone number, or open an attached file. Just like anything you do in edit mode, you can customize link settings without affecting design. So we'll link this button to the order page. So, we've edited text and links. It's time to edit assets. If I click into this image, I can check the source for the alt text on it by clicking the little cog icon, which opens the image settings. Or I can replace it by clicking the little image icon. This will open the assets panel on the left, where I can then select another image. And I have full access to the assets panel, so I can add, delete, and manage all assets, not just images, but documents and Lottie animations as well. Now, one important note: multiple people can edit a site at the same time, so be aware that the last edit on any element wins. So you'll want to coordinate if you're editing with your teammates. Okay, let's quickly recap what we just did. We edited text content, we edited links, and finally, we edited assets. Webflow University shows how to use edit mode to update or replace all types of content, so check that out for more detailed info. But that's editing static content in edit mode in the designer.